Morning. Hey everybody, it's Pastor Ethan. Here with another daily devotional from the 5-Hour for Kids devotional book. And today is Wednesday, April the 8th, and today's heading is Talking with God. Finding the Bible. Philemon 4-5 says, I always thank my God as I remember you in my prayers, because I hear about your love for all his holy people and your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. What do you talk about with God? Maybe you pray about the things you need or people you're concerned about. Perhaps you have a big test coming up or some AMI packets, and you want God to give you the focus as you study hard and take your test. Tell me, remember what you learned. God is pleased when you bring your needs to him, but he also likes to hear more than just requests. Paul told Philemon that he always thanked God for him because of all the good Philemon was doing for God. An easy outline for prayer uses three phrases. First, say, thank you. Tell God how much you appreciate who he is and all he's done for you. Next, say, I'm sorry. Confess all your wrong actions and attitudes to him. And the last three phrases is a simple one. Please, now ask him to take action. For example, maybe heal someone who's sick, help you along with your siblings at home, or maybe bring your parents home safely from a work trip. Then take a few minutes just to listen quietly to God. Pray, give God a chance to bring to mind something he wants to tell you. Prayer is a conversation with your very best friend. So today, maybe take it this way. Pray. P stands for praise. Give God praise. Tell him everything that he has done good for you. And you know what often helps when you first get started with prayer? Just write it down. Maybe a parent help you write down your praise to God. Thank him for everything he's done, then repent. Repentance means that we confess our sins to God. And then we ask. This is the part where we say, God, here's what I need help with today. And then the Y stands for yield. You know those triangle signs that mean slow down, take time, and observe what God is doing in your life. Yield to the presence of God in your life. Don't just ask and then, oh, that's all I got for today. Yield and wait for God to speak to you, because kids, he will. Hey guys, I hope you have a great day today. I hope you're blessed. I hope you enjoyed our New Life Kids midweek last night. If you didn't get a chance to watch it, you can go back and watch it today on the social. Let me pray for you today. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you are not only a God that hears our prayers, God, but you answer our prayers today, God. Lord, as we spend time in prayer, God, would you respond to us? God, would you allow our children to feel your presence in the room, just flooding the room with them as they lift up their praises to you, God, as they repent and as they ask, God, and then they're in that yielding time. Let him feel your presence today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Hey guys, thank you so much for being here and a part of another New Life Kids devotional. And we'll catch you next time out here on the social.